It is really important to know how an aircraft flies at night. So the mechanical operation of an airplane at night is no different than operating the same airplane during the day. The airplane does not know if it is being operated in the dark or the bright sunlight, as it is a man-made machine. So it performs and responds to the control inputs by the pilot only. The pilot, however, is affected by various aspects of night operations and must take them into the consideration during night flight operations. So some are actually physical limitations affecting all the pilots, while others, such as equipment requirements, procedures, and emergency situations, must also be considered. So generally what happens is, most pilots are poorly informed about the night visions during their training. And as well as another factor is that human eyes are never function as effectively at night as the eyes of the animal with nocturnal habits. So it is sometimes happened that human vision is not as effective as the night as compared to the day. So here you can see a little live image. So here you can see an aircraft is approaching towards landing, but it has no view outside the cockpit. And in such a case, pilot has to directly depend upon the control unit, upon the control unit of an aircraft. So let us discover how an aircraft takeoff or landing is proceeded while a very bad cockpit view. So here is another live image of an aircraft landing at the night. So here you can see in the runway that there are a lot of light and marking as well. So I'm going to tell you about all these lights and markings as well. So first we'll talk about some basics. So before beginning a night flight, carefully consider personal equipment that should be readily available during the flight, to include a flashlight, aeronautical charts, and pertinent data for the flight, and a flight deck checklist containing the procedure for all the tasks, which can be found in 14 CFR Part 91. So what are these basic procedures? So these are: before starting engines, before takeoff, cruise, before landing, after landing, stopping engines, and the emergencies. Okay, so in this image, you can see a few light, one a red, green, and white beam on the tail. So these lights have some meaning. So I'll be telling you everything about it. So first, I'll talk about the anti-collision lights. That is as red. So these red lights you can see are the anti-collision lights, and these lights on top and the bottom of the aircraft, and these are often called as the rotating beacons. Then coming up to another second anti-collision light, that is white. So here you can see in the wingtip the white light on each side. The white light. So these are the anti-collision lights, and these lies on the each of the wingtip, and sometimes it also lies on the tail. And these are also named as strobes. Now we have a few pictures, and I'll be explaining. So, like on an aircraft, you can see various lights, like some on the fuselage, wingtips, on the empennage. So each light has some meaning, right? So first we'll talk about the logo light. So logo light, here you can see it's for the first aircraft. It is here, the logo light. So the logo light are mounted on the horizontal stabilizer, as you can see over here, as well as sometimes they are mounted on the wingtips. So during the night, like to determine the airlines on time of the aircraft, so logo lights are there to highlight the logo for particular airlines. So that is why the logo lights are used. Then coming up to the next is wing inspection lights. So these are, here you can see, they are presented on the wing area of an aircraft. So these are used for the inspection, as well as these are also used to increase the aircraft visibility. Coming up to the next, the anti-collision light, that is white light, which I told you earlier, that it lies on the each of the wingtip of an aircraft wing section, and sometimes it's also on the tail, and these lights are known as strobes. Now, coming up to the next, that is the position light. So the position light basically tells the position of an aircraft to which direction it is heading, right? So here you can see the white, green, and red. So position light is also known as a navigation light, and I'll be just briefly telling you about its positions. So now, if I talk about further, that is alternative landing light systems. So here you can see the white lights, right? These are used for the alternating landing light systems. So the landing lights, here you can see the white light. So these are used while the landing, and it is situated on the landing gear, fuselage, as well as in the wings. So coming up to the next, the anti-collision lights, red. These two I told you earlier, that these lie on top and the bottom of an aircraft, and these are also known as the rotating beacons. So coming up to the next is a runway turnoff and taxi lights. So here you can see it is lying on the fuselage as well as the nose area. So these lights are not as bright as the landing lights, but yes, they are used while runway and taxi. So these illuminate runway, exit, and taxiways. Okay, so here is a little nomenclature and the briefing about the lights which are present on an aircraft. So starting, we will start with the nose area of an aircraft. So first we have is the taxi light, which is present over here, the center point that is marked as a white. So this is this white light present at the nose area is known as the taxi light. And this is not much brighter as the landing gear light. Then coming up to the next is wing illumination light. So here you can see these two points, one and two, both white in color. So these are the wing illumination light. Then next comes as retractable landing light. These two another points, same as the white color. These are the retractable landing light, which are used while landing gears are retracting. Then coming up to the runway takeoff lights. So you might have seen an aircraft taking off and flashing some lights. So yes, these are the runway turnoff light. Then we have fixed landing light. Here you can see on the wing section. That is the fixed landing light. Then coming up next is the upper and lower anti-collision lights, which I told you earlier that lies red in color, one at the top and another at the bottom. So these are the anti-collision lights. Then coming up next to the strobe lights, the lights which I told that is anti-collision lights, which lies on the each wingtip, that is also known as strobe light. Then coming up to the position lights as well. So yes, so the lights which is we can see on the each wingtip and the tail, these tell the position of an aircraft. Then we have this logo light. So logo light generally we can see at the vertical stabilizer of an aircraft. So that is the nomenclature of the positioning of the light of on an aircraft. Now, as I have told you about the position light, or we can say the navigational light. So here in the middle, you can see an aircraft. So on the left wing, you can see the red light. In the right wing, you can see the green light. And on the tail, you can see the white light. So now talking about the first case. If you see the white light at the left and the red light at the right, so green at the right, so this position of an aircraft means that aircraft is moving left to right, from left to the right. And coming up to the second case, if you see the red light at the left and the white light at the right, that means that aircraft is moving from right to left. If in third case, you see the green light at the left and the red light at the right, that means the aircraft is coming towards you, like aircraft is incoming, it is coming towards you. And in the third case, in the fourth case, if you see the red light at the left, and then in the middle, you are watching the white light, and at the right, green. So that means the aircraft is outgoing, like going away from you. So here I have shown a little picture you can see over here. So this basically represents the right angle of an aircraft. So aircraft light. So red light, it flashes upon to the 110 degrees from the left wing. Similarly, the green, it flashes from the 110 degrees from the right wing. And for the tail light, it expands upon the 140 degrees. So these position I told you, the navigational light or the positional light. So here you can clearly see if you are watching the red light at the left and the right light, green light at the right. So this means the aircraft is facing away from you, right? And coming up to next, here you can see the green light at the left and the red light at the right. So here you can see the aircraft is facing towards you. And if you are looking from the above, of looking down on a plane, like you are above this plane and an aircraft is going down from you, so you will see such a view you get. And if you just see a green light here, that means, and here would be the white light. So this means that aircraft is going towards right, it is facing right. And if you see a red light and the white light over here, so that means the aircraft is moving towards the left direction. And this is the view of the looking down on a plane. And this is how the plane will look if you look up at the plane. Now, moving on to the runway. So on a single runway, you can see various markings as well as the lights. So each light has some meaning. And here I'll tell you. So first, we'll start with the runway end lights. So this represents the runway where it is going to end. So the center line, you can see, this is the runway end light, which represents that runway has ended at this point. Then coming up to the next, the runway center line lights. So here you can see the center light. These are used to to tell that yes, this is the runway center. Then coming up to next is the touchdown zone light. So touchdown zone lights represents the area or the circle in the runway where aircraft while land has to touch down at this particular area. So up to this marking, an aircraft has to touch down the runway. Then comes up is the threshold lights, and here on the blue marking you can see the blue marking of light. These are the taxiway lights, and here just before the runway, these portion of light, these are known as the approach light, that an aircraft has to while an aircraft has to approach. So these are used for the approach lights. So here's another nomenclature of an aircraft runway. So the single white lights, can you see these white lights, the dots, these represent the runway edge lights, that represent the edge of the runway. Then coming up the yellow dots, the yellow light, this also represents the runway edge lights. You can see over here, the runway edge lights. Then you can see small white square markings over here. These small square markings on white. So these are the runway center line lights. You can see it is representing the center of the runway, right? So coming up the next, you can see the marking as yellow, green, and yellow. So this yellow, green, and yellow, these markings. So these are the exit way, taxiway, lead of lights. Like after an aircraft, so it has to exit the runway. Like you can see the runways like this. And once the aircraft has touched down, so it has to exit the runway. So this represents the exit taxiway. So he can exit the runway, taxi to this way. Then coming up to the next is the red and the green light. Green lights. So this represents the runway end or threshold lights, which means the runway has ended. Then here you can see the bright white lights. Here you can see it is glowing over each end. Here you can see it is glowing, right? So these represent the runway end identifier lights. So here you can see these flashing lights represents the runway ending. So while landing in aircraft, we have a parking system in aircraft. So this is the precision approach path indicator, which tells that if your landing position is accurate or not with respect to the runway. So for a standard, like you can see here a few marking of four dots and they're filled with red dots, right? So the standard nomenclature for this is that for the right side, you should have these marking as this, and it is a standard marking. Okay, like if your aircraft is indicating such markings, then you are going on a right way. But if your aircraft is showing these exact markings, so what is the position of the aircraft with respect to the precision approach and path indicator? So in the first case, you can see if all of your four dots are white, that means the path of an aircraft with respect to the runway is very high. Okay. And in the second case, if it shows only a single red dot, then it means that the path of an aircraft with respect to the runway is little high. And if it shows a two red dots as shown over here, that means the aircraft is following the correct path, that it is correctly following the procedure and path. And what if the dots are three? Then that means it is the aircraft is really at the low altitude. And if that has all of the dots as four, that means the aircraft is really at the too low level. So this is the standard marking. You see. So here is another nomenclature about the runway taxi runway light. So green, as I told, this is representing the center wheel taxiway center line, right? And the blue over here, it is showing the taxiway edge light. Then we have the runway guard light, which is red in color. Then there are steady bar lights, and there are clearance bar light, which is as yellow in color. So another nomenclature. So blue, which is representing the taxiway edge light. Yellow is representing the center line of the runway. So the stop bar lights. So stop bar light is over here. Like after the aircraft has landed and it has to exit the runway and to reach on the taxiway. So this is the stop bar light, that an aircraft can't go beyond this light. And this two yellow dots, yellow color light, these are the runway guard lights. Then these clearance bar lights, you can see over there here. These are the clearance bar lights. Then here you can see the dash lights. These are the taxiway hold line, that if an aircraft is taxiing from the this position and it needs to get on the runway, and he is not get a clearance from the ATC, like there could be another aircraft in the runway. So an aircraft proceeding from this point should have to wait over here. So this is known as the taxiway hold line. And another we have is the runway hold line over here, these two. So this is the runway hold line. So here is another briefing as I have already talked about. So these lights are the approaching light systems. Then there we have the runway and identification lights. Then we have, here you can see these two red dots. So this is representing the path of an aircraft with respect to the runway, that if it is approaching, its approaching altitude is like okay or not. Then we have is the runway center line lighting system. The center line representing the center line of the runway. Runway edge lights, touchdown zone, and runway end light. Okay, so all of you must be familiar, like an aircraft needs to have an instrument landing system while approaching to the runway for the landing purpose. So here I'll be briefing a little about the instrument landing system. So here in the first image, you can see the normal approach and like it is representing the basic need of instrument landing system. So what if we don't use an ILS, so what would happen? So in the first picture, you can see that the normal approach angle is mentioned as the yellow dots, but an aircraft is descending at a very low level, right? So it will approach before the runway, like it will touch down before the runway starts. And if the runway is a little wider, so normal approach angle would be here and the aircraft will be touched down here due to the illusion. So this you can see from another view as well. So here you can see normal approach and the real approach of an aircraft. So these are some illusions which could be created, which could be happen like when an aircraft is landing due to the not clear visibility outside the cockpit. So in such case, instrument landing system is some system which enables an aircraft to give the accurate readings and very precise coordinates to land on the runway. So earlier that I was talking about the illusions, right? So what are such illusions? And also they are named as the black hole. So why does this happen? Mostly when there is a little less view outside the cockpit and then pilot is not aircraft to examine while its approaching angle is accurate with respect to the runway or not. So the black hole approach illusion occurs when approaching the runway at the night or in a poor visibility with no lights before the runway and with city lights or rising terrain beyond the runway. Like you must all be familiar that an airport has to be in an area like up a little beyond of the city, because at the night we need runway light is the only way left to land, right? And if we if an airport having a city nearby, so the pilot approaching for the landing would be confused by the city lights as well. So, and if an airport runway with the nearby city lights is there, so there will be some errors. So these conditions may produce the visual illusion of a high altitude final approach. So if you believe this illusion, you may respond by descending below to the normal approach slope. So a pilot would think that he is approaching at the normal angle, but no, that would be an illusion angle, which is described over here in the picture. So needs to check the altitude against the range for all approaches, monitors, and vertical speeds. Okay, so now I have a video. So that video is basically an aircraft landing.
Landing.
These are special approaching lights. And here is the center line.
The wind 290-17, gust 22, clear to take off runway 24 right.
30.
Keep her alert right, clear to take off runway
39. Reach on. for reverse green. Manual braking.
Okay, so that was all about the